first, the American League, it's Toronto on top, and they have won it all as they defeated the New York Yankees yesterday, and they have a three-game lead with one game to play. So Toronto on top in the American League East. Kansas City in an extra-inning ball game won yesterday, and California finishing second, so that race is over. And taking a look at the National League West, the Dodgers clinched it a week ago, so they have won, and they'll be playing in the National League Championship playoffs. And the St. Louis Cardinals winning yesterday with the Mets losing, the Cardinals winning in the National League East. In a real dog-eat-dog series back on September 13th, it concluded on the 13th, and the Mets had taken two of the three games from the Cardinals. The Cardinals played outstanding baseball. They won 18 and lost 5 of their next 23 ball games. The Mets played very well, won 14 and lost 9 of their 23 ball games, but the Mets unable to overtake the Cardinals, with the Cardinals playing outstanding baseball. We have as our guest Davey Johnson, the manager of the New York Mets. And Davey, no champagne this year.
No, I'll have to wait till next year, Al.
Wait till next year. Of course, that's a famous saying that was made famous in Brooklyn all those years. They finally won it in 1955.
It's no fun saying it, I'll tell you that.
Well, it was a great year for you, and of course you said over and over again that second place is not the answer. You want first place, and you finished second now 2 years in a row in your first 2 years in the major league. So what are you going to do about next year?
Well, I think next year, you know, injuries played a big part in this year. We have to stay away from injuries next year, but we need to beef up our pitching staff a little bit. I think if one area where we were a little bit weak was in our long relief, and we have to have better years out of the guys we have there, or pick up some other guys.
We'll be back to talk with Davey Johnson in just a moment, right after this message from Mitsubishi. And Davey, the ball club played very well down the line, and the Cardinals, of course, played just a little bit better. Any part in this season that you would pick out as the turning point in the season?
Well, I'd have to pick out early on in the season when we were 18-8 and Darryl got hurt. We didn't play well for about 6 weeks. I think our record was 20-23. But you take that out, and we played better than anybody in the game. You know, we just played outstanding. The Cardinals, they say they had a better September. We actually, percentage points-wise, were better than the Cardinals in the last month. I think we were 19-9 in September, and they were 21-10. So we didn't choke going down the stretch either.
Well, there's no doubt about that. You played outstanding baseball down the line. Went to St. Louis and won 2 out of 3. Of course, that last ball game you lost by 1 run. That was a tough loss.
It sure was. You know, I got second-guessed, I'm sure, by you and everybody else probably on
no,
that.
No, not by me.
By not starting Dwight the first game, but we really needed all three there. And, you know, we had opportunities in that third game to win the ball game, and they just kind of inflicted small wounds on us. The little breaks didn't go our way, and things didn't happen right. But once we lost that game, it was kind of academic as far as I was concerned.
In that third game, the Mets had 4 base hits and scored only 1 run. And, of course, the Mets in that inning, there were tremendously good defensive plays pulled off against the Mets in that inning. The one by McGee on the ball hit by Mookie Wilson, the play off the line drive off the wall by Hernandez, by Van Slyke, and then also the play by Pendleton. So defense really hurts you right there.
Well, the first inning was the key. We should have knocked Cox out that first inning. It would have been a whole new ball game. A lot of little breaks, like you were mentioning, went against us, and you know, Keith should have been on second base. We'd have got another run that inning, but getting Cox out of the ballgame and getting into their bullpen early, that would have been the big key.
One of the things about the Mets that's kind of ironic, they have a fine record against left-hand pitching, but every time you turned around, especially in relief, they brought in left-handers. How can you compensate for that?
Well, the only way you can compensate is really get a little stronger bench. You know, when Ray Knight's playing, I really only had one veteran hitter to come off the bench, and that was Pashorek. We need to beef up there, because I think it is a weakness, even though we played very well against left-hand pitching, and we won a lot of ball games. We need to have a long ball threat on the right side coming off the bench.
Anybody in mind?
Cedeno.
Well, you know, speaking of Cedeno, that was really the difference, I think, in what Herzog has said, that Cedeno, yeah. When they picked him up from Cincinnati, he hit something like 6 home runs, batted well over 400, and drove in a lot of important runs.
Well, I meant to ask Whitey while I was there about how he did that, because, you know, we lost Darryl for 2 months, and we didn't pick up anybody. And it's in a pennant race right at the end, and I don't know who he gave for Cedeno. He must have, you know, maybe some minor leaguer down in A-ball or something, but I just can't imagine, with Cincinnati in a pennant race too, how they could pick up a guy like Cedeno.
Well, he wasn't playing, and the story I heard was the fact that Jim Codd had breakfast with Whitey Herzog and said he was available. So Whitey said, you got to be kidding. And so they went out and they picked him up. I don't know what they gave for him.
I'm going to have to
start
having more breakfast with these pitching coaches around the league.
That's right. Well, David Johnson, you had an outstanding year this year. I'm sorry you didn't win. I'm sure all the Met fans certainly. Well, yesterday the fans showed their appreciation for a great performance.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, that was a heart-rending moment for me. I saw it go up on the board, and then I looked at the fans, and they started standing up and clapping. And, you know, if I was ever going to break down, it was going to be right then and there because it was a very emotional time.
You're going to break down on the golf course and give more strokes this winter?
I polished up my clubs and started massaging them and talking to them. We're going to get to be good friends this winter.
Not unless you change your handicap, I'll tell you that. David Johnson. David, congratulations.
Thanks, Ralph.
We'll be back with more of the special edition of Kiner's Corner in just a moment after this word from Mitsubishi Motors. Long, but the most crucial week of the season started on Tuesday of this past week. Mets coming to St. Louis, and it's showdown time in the Show Me State, and it's time to get it on. Tuesday night, game number one of the series, scoreless through 10 innings. Ken Daly on the mound, Darryl Strawberry at the bat, and Darryl takes it way downtown, and the Mets win it by a score of 1-0. Tudor had hooked up with Darling in a scoreless pitching duel until the 10th. With Jesse Orozco in relief, two men out, Tommy Herr on third. Yvonne De Jesus is at the plate. The tension is tough. And here's the pitch, and the Mets come up with a victory as De Jesus flies out for the final out of the ballgame as Mookie Wilson puts it away. Mets win game number one by a score of 1-0, the first leg of what the hopeful Mets hope will be a big sweep of the three-game series. It's Fred Bird taking the aim right there as we take a look at the second game of the big important series. It's Wednesday night, top of the first, one out, Backman on third, Hernandez on first base, walking under on the mound, and Gary Carter singles to center, scoring Backman, and the Mets go up by a score of 1-0. In the bottom of the ninth inning, with two men out, bases loaded, Mets holding on to a 5-2 lead, and Dwight Gooden pitching, Tommy Herr lines out to Backman, and the Mets win the ball game by a score of 5-2, and the Cardinal lead now cut to one game. In game number three on Thursday, bottom of the fourth inning, two men out, runners on second and third. Ozzie Smith and Darryl Porter, the runners. Rick Aguilera in the mound. Vince Coleman singles with this soft hit in the left field. And with the score tied at 1-1, the Cardinals now take the lead by a score of 3-1. Now in the top of the ninth inning, Gary Carter at bat. Cardinals leading by a score of 4-3. Jeff Lottie gets the final out, throwing one pitch, and the Cardinals win the ball game 4-3, and they increase their lead to two full games over the New York Mets. Mets able to win two, but not the third game of the three-game series. So it ain't over till the Fat Lady sings, and Mets return to Shea Stadium. It's Keith Hernandez at the plate. Friday night, bottom of the first. Keith with a three-base hit. Mookie Wilson, who was on second base, scores, and the Mets take the lead by a score of 2-0. Backman also scoring on the play. Bottom of the eighth inning, the Mets leading by a score of 8-4, and Mookie Wilson takes one downtown. Mookie getting all of that curveball, and the Mets add on one more run and lead by a score of 9-4. And that was the way the ball game ended, as the Mets won the very first game with the Montreal Expos. Meanwhile, in St. Louis, fireworks as the Cardinals leading by a score of 2-0. Ozzie Smith triples to right field, driving in Darryl Porter from third base, and the Cardinals increase their lead to 3-0. Ozzie Smith cruising into third base with a stand-up triple. Going to the top of the ninth inning, the Cardinals leading by a score of 4-2. Jody Davis flies to Pendleton for the third out, and the Cardinals win their ballgame by that score of 4-2. Saturday at Shea Stadium in the top of the first inning, Andre Dawson. The pitcher is Ron Darling, and Dawson on a 3-1 pitch lines it over the right field fence, and the Montreal Expos take a lead of 2-0. Dawson picking up his 22nd home run of the year. Then in the bottom of the eighth inning, a look at Gary Carter. After the Mets had seen the Cardinals score, the Cardinals winning by 7-1, and that's the way it ended. Cardinals pulling in with a 7-1 victory, so everything for the Mets is academic, although Darryl Strawberry contributed to the action in the bottom of the eighth inning when he hit his 29th home run. That's the most he's ever hit as a New York Met, And the final score of that ball game, the Expos 8, the Mets 3. But even though the Mets lost and the St. Louis Cardinals were winning, the Mets had something to celebrate as they announced...